Hey guys, welcome back to my channel where I feature unique spaces. In today's video, we're revisiting Tim in Florida on his private island. In a previous video, I took you on a tour of Tim's tiny house on wheels, which he still lives in full time. Today, he's showing us his foundation tiny home, which he uses to host Airbnb guests. This video is a continuation of my channel's partnership with Airbnb, where I show you some of the most unique rentals around the country and share the stories behind the hosts that own them. So, without further ado, let's jump right in.
Hi, my name's Tim, and this is Shellmate Island. Before purchasing Shellmate Island and hosting guests, I was living in my own tiny house in an RV campground for the last few years. Living in such a small space really helped me understand the benefits of tiny living, and I fell in love with the concept of minimalism. I wanted to share that feeling with others, so I had the idea of Shellmate Island. Offering a unique vacation rental to my guests is rewarding in so many different ways. First, I love sharing the island and the concept of tiny living with others. I really like to show people what tiny living can bring to them and also be able to see families and friends create memories that they'll hopefully remember for a long time. But also financially, it helps me cover almost all my living expenses. I'm able to park my tiny house here, enjoy the property, enjoy people, and offer them a glimpse of an alternative lifestyle. It's really a win-win situation for me, and I'll continue doing this for many years to come.
So I found the property itself on Zillow, and the property itself was for sale for 2 years and just an astronomical price. So I actually went and knocked on the seller's door and introduced myself and asked to, you know, I was interested in his property, but I wasn't willing to pay what he was asking for and the reasons why. I didn't have utilities. I had a contract with him and was able to get 60 days to figure out if I was able to even build a tiny house out here, and in that process found that it was a good fit for what I needed. The structure itself took 24 hours to build since it was a panel system, but the overall project took about a year and a half. So the location of the home's in Sarasota, Florida, Siesta Key, which is the number one beach in Florida. On the property itself on Shellmate, it's an acre and a half, so there's plenty of space to do different things in the cabana area, hang out, eat, and play some games, as well as the nice fire pit area I find, you know, most people enjoy. The house itself is 320 square feet and it can sleep four people, two in one bed and two in another bed. Some of the unique features of the tiny house would be the lighting I did. It is RGB tunable white, so what that means is that it does every color in the rainbow as well as every Kelvin temperature. So what I'm able to utilize that with is change the Kelvin temperature or the whites of the lights to mimic the natural Kelvin temperature of the sun outside throughout the day. So it can start as like a nice warm white and throughout the day at noon, a nice cool white, and then go back down to a warm white. And what that does is help with like circadian rhythms and sleeping patterns, as well as feel like there's more light in a space, especially it being tiny. I think it helps utilize it not feeling as small. It's 320 square feet, but the cool part about it is that it's an octagon, and what that means is it's good for high winds, for hurricanes down here in Florida. It doesn't allow the wind to have a single panel to have pressure on it, so it really is more aerodynamic, as well as the roof truss systems are like spokes on a wheel and they all meet in the middle. And the nice part about that is if wind tries to lift up from one of the corners, the other trusses or spokes on the wheel help reinforce it to keep the roof from flying off. Over here is the grilling area. I have my hydroponic system that I just got, and I'm growing some kale and lettuce for the first time. And the squirrels are starting to eat some of it, which I guess I don't mind, but they don't get the higher ones. And then I built a DIY wood fire pizza oven. This is the cabana area. It used to be an old boat port. I didn't want to tear it down, and so it was crooked. It still is crooked, but it's more reinforced now. Let's check it out. So the cool part of this area is everything in here was free. I'm a big Craigslister. But it's a nice area to get out away from mosquitoes and out of the sun. I redid the roof to help be more reflective to keep the heat off as well as seal it. So over here I have a fire pit. Living so close to Siesta Key, I wanted to make sure that I had kind of like some sand on my area. And so I brought in white silicone sand, which resembles the Siesta Key sand. So it's kind of nice being able to come out here and, you know, roast marshmallows and have a campfire with friends and still be able to like kind of kick the shoes off and still feel like you're at the beach. Over here is the banana trees. So I really like having this here because I obviously they're fruit trees, but it helps with privacy. And then the rest of the property is mainly has privacy through Brazilian pepper. So it really feels like I'm kind of in the middle of everything, but I have the complete privacy with like no neighbors or anybody snooping on me. And then this is Tiffany. So Tiffany is set here now. Yeah, it's been working out great. And it's nice being able to be so close, being able to have everything one piece of land. And then this is my shed. This was originally here when I bought the property, and the original owners built it 50 years ago, and it's still standing. And I think it's nice. I'm able to keep like my yard equipment, my kayaks, and you know, stuff that I can work on, my tools. Also, I have this nice massive driveway. It used to go into the middle of the property. I had to redesign the driveway, and I used this like nice white gravel to help with durability, and there's plenty of parking and space for everybody. The island itself is an acre and a half, and I think this probably takes up a half. When I originally bought the property, there was no utilities out here, so I actually had to bring utilities in. I had to build the septic tank as well as bring in water and electric. The electric was actually bored underground, 8 feet underground, and it uses a machine that it's almost like a needle and it pops out the other end. And then I can attach it to the house, and then ran water all the way down from the street. Come on in. I got a queen size bed here. Nice soft memory foam mattress. Cool little teak table I found on Craigslist free, and I fixed it up, cleaned it up, and I think it's great for a nice nightstand. Having these two windows is nice in here, as well as the lights. With these windows really opens this space up. I kept the top of this wall open in order to let more air in from the AC unit. Our pocket doors here, nice cool louver doors. Being able to have a full length door is pretty nice in here. This is the living room. I decided to do polished concrete floors throughout the home, one for the durability of it, and two, it being the foundation of the home, it actually helps keep the place cooler. I found this couch actually online, but the cool part about this couch is that it actually folds out into a full length bed. So it being 320 square feet, I still technically have two beds in the tiny house, which is kind of nice. This is what I call like the bar breakfast area. I like this area because when that second bed's out, I can fold it down in order to create more room to get back and forth. Thought it was a great way to utilize the space even more. a 1920 Kohler sink. So I picked this up at a flea market and then repurposed it. And then I made this cool shelf system with LEDs. I think having that open shelves as well as that extra space in the kitchen makes it feel even bigger. Apartment style fridge, and then another pocket door, and this pocket door has a full length mirror on the outside. All right, now this is the bathroom, full flush toilet, which is cool. I also have a washer dryer combo in here. I like this one just because it uses heat instead of steam in order to dry. It seems to dry the clothes a lot better. And then I built this little cabinet area in order to have storage for, you know, towels and beach towels and things like that, but as well as like having a nice folding area. Big open shower. It's a weird shape, which it was my first tile work and a little difficult, but it's super spacious and I got a rainfall shower head. Corner sink. I actually found this one online just because it fit the space so perfectly. Some of my favorite guest reactions is when they talk about memories. It's my first time being in a hospitality industry, but being able to see parents and kids make memories on the island. It's a big investment to build or buy a tiny house, and being able to rent one and see whether you like it or not is kind of an interesting concept that I think I hope most people take away. Plans for the future right now is just to kind of stay put. I'm enjoying living out here and I'm enjoying renting to people and hosting experiences, and I'm excited to see what that brings me.
I hope you guys enjoyed this week's video. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next week with an all-new video.